Hi, I'm JD. This is Jeffrey, and this is Hunter. We study game design. Yep, we study game design. We're all computer science students that have started a game company called Witchfish Studios.
So what exactly does it do?
But before we get there, we need to go there. And before we get to that, we need to talk about this. In the fall of 2023, Jeffrey and I took a game design class together. It was focused on making board game prototypes so that we could start learning the basics of what makes a good game. We were partnering with a local museum that wanted an educational game on their website. Everyone in the class spent about 8 weeks making their own prototype and presenting them to the museum. Mine ended up fitting their vision the best, so it was then taken to next semester's class where it was made into a web game. Jeffrey and I were also in this class together. Over the course of 15 weeks, we made Habitile, a two-player game that's free to play on the web. It's linked below if you want to take a peek. After that, Jeffrey, Hunter, and I became friends. Where'd Hunter come from? Where did Hunter come from? Hunter and I met in a random computer science class. We both liked rock climbing, so we went rock climbing together. Jeffrey also likes rock climbing, and we're all computer science majors, so we just bonded over that and became friends. After a few months of really getting to know each other, the three of us, with the help of three other classmates, participated in Global Game Jam 2024, where we made a game called Snatch and Sniff in about 48 hours. It's a game about stealing things and sniffing them without getting thrown out of the convention. You can also play this one, but please remember that it was made in 48 hours. Over the course of this last year, Jeffrey released a game on Steam with his company called Sphere Province Games called Mission Rovi. It was for his final capstone project, and as you can tell, it's very popular. So we all have a few games under our belt, but we had this idea about 6 months ago that we should try to make a game that isn't related to school and could actually maybe make us some money. So how is that going?
Markiplier. We had so much Markiplier coming in.
Besides that, we have actually been productive. We've been in pre-production for about 6 months now, at first making weekly prototypes and trying to figure out what game is worth spending our time making. Since we're students, we have limited time and money, so it's important to spend time prototyping so that later we don't waste time making a game that sucks. We had a lot of ideas we said no to, including a fishing RPG, a rock climbing simulator, a maze running roguelike, and a bunch more. It took quite a bit of time to find something we were confident in making. During this time, we set up our LLC so that all of our work can be protected and we can start marketing and reaching out for funding. We had an amazing opportunity through our university's entrepreneurship program that gave us the funding to build our website, set up our Steam profile, and pay artists and video editors to help us. This is Sam, our artist. Look at this cool stuff they make, like this, and this, and also this. They worked on Snatch and Sniff with us, and they've made all of the really cool drawings you've seen so far in this video. And this is Zach, our video editor. He's been editing videos for years and has a background in broadcast engineering. He's also a good friend of ours. Thanks to our university's funding, we don't have to do all of this ourselves, and we can focus on creating the gameplay. After a couple of months of prototyping, we landed on an idea that we liked. A multiplayer, roguelike, crazy eights deck builder, which I understand is just a lot of words thrown together. The idea is that each player can individually change the deck that everyone draws from. There are normal playing cards, and there are special cards that change the way you play the game. Jeffrey created a physical prototype of this that we, and all the people we tested with, agreed was pretty fun. Since we have our core idea locked in, we're focusing on creating a vertical slice. A vertical slice, as defined by Richard LeMarchand in A Playful Design Process, which is a textbook we had to read for class, is a high-quality demo of your game. It includes a sample of most, if not all, of the core features of your game that are essential to the player's experience. It's like how you don't need to eat the entire cake to know what the cake tastes like. You just need one slice to get the cake and the icing and the filling. You don't need an entire game to be made before you know if it's good. You just need a vertical slice to know if the core features are going to work. So far, as for what we've actually made in the engine, it's really just crazy eights. Players can draw cards from the deck and play cards if they have a matching number or color. There are skip cards, reverse cards, wild cards, +2s, and +4s. Pretty basic stuff for card games like this. It's simple, but we need this foundation to be completely functional before we can make it crazy and fun, like we have in our prototype. We've implemented a few placeholder assets so that we can implement these features while Sam works on making the assets that will actually be in the vertical slice. As for the features we want to implement, we want there to be cards that make permanent changes to the deck. One idea we have for this is the burn card, which permanently removes a card from the deck. Another would be a transformer modifier, where every card that comes into your hand becomes a certain suit. These would make the game chaotic, fun, and give you the ability to make a great deck for yourself while sabotaging your friend's ability to play on it. There will be more specific content updates as we go, but that's our goal for right now. The best part of coming from a computer science background is that we get to implement the software engineering principles we've learned into our game's construction. We're building our game in Godot Engine. Every game we've mentioned so far in this video was made in Godot Engine, and we all love working in it. A lot of the tools we use revolve around this being the engine we use, so I'm going to go into some of the tools we use that make that easier. We're using GD Script Toolkit to enforce the GD Script Style Guide. We use GUT, Godot Unit Testing, to test our game automatically so that we can never leave the game in a broken state, even if we tried. We're using a Scrum-inspired methodology where we prioritize our work using user stories, making sure to implement things that are most important to the player first. Hack and Plan has been a super helpful tool for doing this. It's been a fun 6 months working on this, but we still have a ton of work ahead, including most of the game to make. Now that we have our user stories laid out, we're excited to be regularly updating this until it's something good. We're students, so we've got a lot to learn, but it's a journey we're excited to go on. Thanks for watching!